Hello everyone, welcome back to Let's Play Metroid Prime 3. Metroid Prime 3? God, I'm definitely not in the freak frame of mind. Metroid Prime Remastered. You can tell what I've been playing recently. I almost did it again. Wouldn't say Metroid Prime 3. No, Xenoblade Chronicles 3. I usually don't stand in that platform, so... Triclops. It gathers small bits and creatures of bits and few stuff and then deposits them somewhere else for later consumption in the heart. Triplet mandibles use it to quite strong to escape or to snare. Those guys, these guys are annoying. Also, yeah. We need to actually roll down here. Not get spelled by them. I just said not get spelled by them. I hate these guys. I'm gonna get so much damage. Yes, by purposely destroying them all. Once we get the high jump boots, we won't worry about them. Because really, they are really annoying. This room must have been used for something else originally. Because it's just such a weird room. escape sequence from here. I'm assuming that this place was probably where the room itself was probably originally for the screw attack, because that's one of the abilities that isn't in this game. But Prime 2 and 3 have it, because the reason why it isn't in this game is because they couldn't get programmed right. Not the fault of developers, the screw attack was just not going to work. Well, we technically can, but we'll eventually hit a roadblock. Which one is it? Oh, it's none of them. Can't go higher. Okay. So this used to be quite hard, but with Spring Ball, we can just do this. Right. There we go. Yeah. It's nice to have some health. And now we're going to Phandrana Drifts. Probably what is most remembered quite fondly, despite having some of the worst things about it. I think the phase of mine still have it worse, but we'll get to those later. I mean, you could use glass, or we can just break him. Oh, still looks nice, even from back then. It still looks so beautiful. Bubbles unlocked, which we do need to do now, later. These guys. Red. Right, can't see anything, so I'm not going to try it under. We do scan. Yeah, try and scan these guys if we can.
Recording to logbook.
Yeah, flicker bats, you want to remember these, and the reason why I want you to scan them is because these guys can really, really will just be quite annoying. And scanning them here is the easiest opportunity, but they can disappear. There are other opportunities to scan them, but this is the easiest. Get to those enemies later. But once I should save room is clear. And Jed's actually opening the path before you go through. And then there's these guys. Can't do anything about them right now. Just try and time. Try and time warp ball. Wait until it comes towards you because it's easier to dodge when it comes towards you. Keep your scan visor on. Oh, not for these guys, but we may need. Yep, we might need to fight these guys first. Shigoffs! Honestly, these variants are not that bad. Just there are other variants that scan visor on because you don't know. Okay, it's not this ruins. I don't think it is. Just keep it on just in case. But from here on out, you want to keep your scan visor on just in case you run into enemies that you don't notice is there. Scan.
Recording to
log. Okay, get rid of these guys as fast as you can before you go forward, and then keep scan visor on. Want as much time as possible, so grab that before you move. Okay, we're up here. Check. Can't scan that. Right, these things. Okay, so 12-hour bets they're talking about are one of the keys to the endgame. If you don't get them, you don't get to endgame. I think we technically can climb up. Be careful, it's the lead. Yeah, I believe I could fall down. Not what I was actually going for. not much to get up there. Okay. Alright, scan these guys before you can, because you won't get many opportunities to scan those guys, because eventually these guys do start appearing less and less. So. That's what we're here to do, effectively. They rarely do that. Alright. One scan this. Another time segment. And we get the boost ball. Finally. It's now Metroid Prime Pinball. Okay. And that's how we're meant to find our way back up. But if I should look into it, if the scanner's playing, there's indeed a fish here. Nice touch. Jump back up. Of course, now I've got this. Sneak past these guys, but it's not very helpful in combat. Ignore these guys. Only if we don't, we have to actually return here. Because I believe we have to get through here. We will return through there. Nice reminding us that Ridley's still a thing. Oh, we can't even get to that. Now, I believe it. We just head back then. But we'll continue forward until we can't go further in Magmore Caverns. Might as well. Remember this, we'll be coming back here for a while. Okay, now we can just go down and we'll have to take that way anyway. I'd rather bring in the missiles early. Gives us some extra missiles to play with. And it means I can be a bit more reckless. Ow. Also, it means I can just hit this guy without hunting for whatever. Granted, dealing with this guy on the way back isn't as fun. But we have a way. Talon overruled West. Return to the ship. Yep, here, because it's another missile expansion. Yeah, we're swimming in missile expansions. Trudging back. Thank you. However, to get this one item, which is half, I feel is kind of pointless. Other than to be immersive. Jump. Make sure you don't miss. And close to where we were. Space jump boots. In the original Metroids, I think specifically Metroid is the most well known of them. This would have been Space Jump, but of course, in a 3D game, that's kind of power, so yeah, no, you're only given a double jump. So let's go save. And you know what? We'll see what's this way. Space Pirates. And they actually flew away. What was this stuff? This may be Phazon. But if you haven't scanned anything that says Phazon, it will actually say on a identified substance, which is a nice touch. I kind of like that. If you aren't scan focused and you don't scan anything, you'll find out, you won't know what it is. But with how close the pirates were, how the hell did they not find our ship? Well, find out later via the scans, but it's because Samus' ship's cloaked. But there is one thing. Yeah, it can be cloaked and unidentified. Something, but so where only Samus can see it. Doesn't stop the raindrops just stopping in midair being something that I find very suspicious. Now it's ready to open. Our first scan. Here. That is hinting at Samus is coming here. The music changes. Chozo Artifact. And this is our end goal, to open the impact barrier. Even a new jingle. This is the Artifact of Truth, the first of 12. Scan the totems here for clues on locations of the remaining artifacts. Together, the artifacts will open a path to the center of the impact barrier. You'll notice not all of them are active. These are the only ones that we can actually technically get. So if we scan them, within the ruins of our home, we honor our fallen elders in a great hall. chamber beneath the statue holds artifact of world.
Recording to
logbook. New artifact trail downloads your logbook. A sun chamber high atop our ruined home became the nest of a great beast, the source of corruption. Many chosen spirits have been drawn to this tainted place. Release their bond to the world to claim the artifact of wild. Okay, so we can't actually do some of these. I don't know why some of these aren't activated then.
Recording to logbook.
Heat of Mad Moor was attested for many. A shrine in their honor holds an artifact of strength. That one. That one's in a weird place, and I would not say that should be where strength is, but hey, I'm not going to argue with Joseph. Talents for Covers, a Grove of Life. Okay, this one we definitely can't get until we get Power Bombs. Yeah, that one we can never scan for its hit. The Visions of Claim Phandrana as their own, a tower. We definitely cannot collect that until we get Plasma Beam. So, this one technically we can do if we can get into it. That one we are technically going to be able to get to, because we are going to be collecting the weapon that we need to be able to get into that room, and we technically can get into that room without a certain ability. It's a certain glitch that I think the devs might have forgotten to patch. Either that or I did really clever speed jump usage. But no, I'm not going to be doing that. I'm going to do it the way that it is intended. Sort of then. And we want to go back to Macro Converse. Because we're going back to Phandrana. Caverns. I will try and at least get through to unlocking the next upgrade. Ends up being positive. Can't get through here yet. Still up. Wait. the single artifact strength is. If I'm remembering correct. It's actually going to be a bit... I can't say it. Lindium. Yeah, I disagree this being strength. I would have called this something else. I think there's a different artifact that I would consider strength. Mainly because there's just... There's nothing to do with any sort of strength, except for a knee strength. Which, I guess they're birds. So I guess that makes sense. Save here. Can't do that, because otherwise they just ram right into us. Where is it? Not you. Better scan those things as well. Because these guys only appear here, I believe. If they appear somewhere else, they're so forgettable at that time, and probably so easy to take out, but... Which is kind of pathetic if that's the case, because... Yeah, they're already pretty easy to deal with. What was here they come into, huh? Alright, scan all these because. I hope you aren't expecting, like, easy puzzles, because from here on out, they started getting pretty cryptic. Like, in some ways, I like that, but in other ways, screw it. This room. the wave beam. Hope you don't expect to just be getting this thing for free. Yeah, no matter what, you can't grab it. Even if you quote-unquote grab it, you'll still fail to. In the original game, I believe you can actually grab it, which is hilarious to me. Try not to waste any missiles. You will want them. Trust me. The babies. Supreme Predator. They're vulnerable to most beam weapons. They're just on their backs, absorb energy which can fire at prey. But they're bad. They can hyperventilate more easily, effectively. They have breathing problems. Hey, there's one thing me and them can at least bond over. I have breathing problems too. Try and get a few charge shots in and try and get two missiles out, dodge, get to fire. They'll sometimes fire volatiles and then they won't. Don't. Don't take risks, so if they fire one, just fire one missile. And it's dead. And meet my favorite looking beam in the game. Wave beam. The wave beam acquired. Oh wait, have we not scanned these?
Recording to logbook.
Well, press X, hold X, and press left, press right, and we've got the wave beam. Yeah, if you've played the original, this is what the wave beam does, but we couldn't angle it. In this game, in Prime, the electrical charge wasn't here. And it was one of the touches that is sad that didn't get put in. Remaster fixes this. But there are some downsides to wave beam, which is what I'm going to talk about before we even leave this room. So, this is how fast the power beam charges. Charge up there. A little bit longer to charge. But then we look at how powerful it is. So this is how much damage it does. Non-charge. This is a charge. It may not seem that different. But because the power beam actually fires faster, it does a bit more damage. But worse, a certain enemy type that we'll get to later is absolutely awful when they have the when you can only damage them with the wave beam. There's other tricks with the wave beam that we can talk about, but we need to wait for when we get the suitable upgrades. Why am I not moving? However, I can tell about one of the things I really love about it is that it actually paralyzes enemies. Also, it heals these guys really easily. It's fun dealing with them with that. Where are the ice shriek bats? Also, Shigloves are appearing here. We'll save first. Oh, might as well show off how. Yeah, notice how. Just. Yeah. Stunned. Now, let us try stunning this guy. And then switch to the power beam. Once he gets away from the edge. If I'm looking on the draw. See? Really useful. Sadly. Can't deal with those guys. So next time, we'll open some wave beam doors and proceed forward and find out what these pirates are doing here. So guys, then, Xenozuma, signing out.